Mr. Heyll?
Ah, Miss McLeod. I've told you before, you can call me Caleb.
And I've said you can call me Alice.
Of course, Alice. Any news?
I'm afraid it's not good news, Caleb. Wyatt's cancer has returned once again, as expected. His visits to Purgatory don't seem to be alleviating his ailment.
Again? Oh, I'm hopeful his trips there give him some comfort. At least every time he comes back, he experiences some modicum of normality.
No. His cancer returns quicker and quicker after each visit, Caleb. Purgatory doesn't heal everything. We were wrong. What shall we do?
We keep trying. The consequences of the Sorrowvirus cannot be reversed, or at least we just don't know how to undo its ramifications.
This isn't fair on Wyatt,
Mr. He's my son! We will keep trying!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Of course.
Make him comfortable. And if you have to, let him die quickly. Maybe the next time he comes back will be different somehow. We need to finish our research on Purgatory and the Soulless as soon as possible. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Renee Heyll, and my husband tends to be the one who does these dictations, but lately I felt compelled to do the same. Wyatt has suffered long enough. Ever since we gave him the sorrow virus, death has been absolutely nothing but a temporary solution for him. I wondered if we could alter the sorrow virus, but Caleb told me we can't modify it due to what happened to his sister when he was younger. It changed her drastically. She's still out there, somewhere.
It's easy to lose track of time in a timeless place. I need to keep checking in with those clocks whenever I can. Leaving it for too long will cause me to age quickly. Leaving it forever, something far worse. Wait! Come back here!
curious to see if he'll be interested to help us after all these years. Wyatt keeps seeing his cousin's name in Purgatory, or at least a jumbled version of it, and I don't know why. I have all the answers he could need, and if he chooses to help us, I'll tell him everything he wants to know. He's never met Wyatt before, but even I know how much family means to him. Caleb wants nothing to do with that side of the family. It's why he took my name when we married. I, however, am more open to the idea of a reunion.
I should have known he'd try to get involved. He doesn't even know Wyatt. He just can't leave us alone. He has to interfere. Roscoe? Heller?
You need me, Caleb?
Yes, I want you to find this man.
Why this guy?
Because it's your job and we're paying you.
Not right now. There's too much.
Roscoe! He killed your sister.
Sorrowvirus again, ever. I'm sorry that you're still there, but you're safe. You're comfortable, I hope. I will see you again after we've completed our research. Oh, why do I bother with this sentimental drivel? It only holds me back.
Thank you.
forget to check in with the clock.
Of residual emotional energy that has built up over the entire course of a person's life cannot amount to nothing. Wakeland City is special. You can see and hear everybody's ghosts there. In the busy and forever active world, however, the energy is fragmented by the constant noise and hubbub. You leave a place quiet for long enough, and soon they'll emerge once more. Do I feel haunted by their wailing screams in the recesses of my mind? I do what I have to do, so others don't.
The worst thing is knowing that even if I were brave enough to put you out of your misery, the Sorrowvirus would just keep bringing you back, making you endure this suffering over and over again. I could get you out of here if I could, but I cannot do it alone. Your cousin will be here soon. Hold on. Just hold on.
When you get to Wakeland City, you must absolutely leave the dolls alone. They do not matter, and they are inconsequential. Your priority is to find the Sorrowvirus. I'm sorry that we can't go ourselves. We're needed here. You are the only one other than ourselves who knows how to find the Sorrowvirus.
Forget to check in with the clock.
Please help me! I don't want to die!
You'll be here forever.
Sorrowvirus doesn't heal a person's ailments. It merely corrupts their soul, rendering it invalid for passing on to the afterlife when they die, causing them to fall to purgatory instead. Purgatory is where the Catholicon lies, a seemingly unlimited quantity of microorganisms that envelop themselves around a fallen being, healing many of their ailments. We need to determine an effective method to harvest these microorganisms so that they may heal just as effectively here as they do in purgatory. Then, and only then, will I be able to save my son. even if he doesn't want to be saved anymore.
Thank you.
forget to check in with the clock. Time is running out. I have to find the clock.
Thank you.
single injury, like a cut from a paranormal entity, and you're doomed. It corrupts your body, turning you into one of the anomalies when you die. These zombies, these ghosts, are merely mindless entities who suffer from a constant fear and the need to kill everything they see.
It's too dark for me to carry on. To check in with the clock. Is running out. I have to find the clock. I should place the doll inside of the ritual zone.
Back now. One way or another, this is how it ends.